Okay, I'm with John Lute on a matter. Hey, John, how you doing?
Good.
John, looks like you like to decorate your house in a purple, green, and gold motif.
Oh, yeah, I love decorating like this. In fact, I already have a list next year of 12 things that I'm going to put together to change it around.
Oh, man, as a kid, you must have been quite a king cake guy.
Oh, yeah, I love to go to king cake parties, and you know what? I'm the guy that like to play spin the bottle and also get the babies.
Oh, man, well, this goes to show you, around this area, people love to decorate the front of their houses in all kinds of ways.
The Romans called them penates, minor gods assigned to watch over the household, and they erected small statues of them all over the grounds. 20 centuries later, some of them are still around. There are those who hide from their hearts the fact that the universe is ordered toward disorder. And the way some of them choose to drive a stake through the heart of chaos is to plant an ornament on their lawns. Gardens and lawns are a form of control over nature. These are a form of control over gardens and lawns. Some of them are noble. Some are playful. Some are solemn. Some are just silly. Some are silly because they're trying to be solemn. And at places like exotic gardens on Airline Highway, you can often find the solemn and the silly not very far from one another. Decorations can be small refinements to break the view, or tributes to the special joy we take from murmuring water. Some are infantile. Others are about love in its many disguises. Part of the charm is figuring out just what these cement surrogates are saying on behalf of the folks inside the house. I might have a little trouble visualizing what lawns and gardens are going to look like in another 20 centuries. I have no trouble at all imagining these things being there, still amused at how they amuse us.